that. Oh, we've been together, together. Come on,
I'm gonna sing for
your friends, are my friends, and my friends are your friends.
Come on, we've been together. Come happier we'll be. Wow, that was a good one. How many of you made it all the way through Rocket Ship? Really? How many people made one mistake or two and got back on? Just as important, fixing our mistakes. Excellent job. Let's do a little question time. Let's figure out who's here. It also is a hard pattern. One, two, three, one, two, three. Keeping that going and singing the 3-4 song at the same time is very difficult. So we've been doing this since January. We're going to keep working on it. We'll show you in May our progress. I think we can all get that rocket ship at the end, right? All right. An answer question is just tuning in their focus, having them answer, narrowing it down to a solo singer. So I can use that to evaluate vocal quality and vocal pitch. So that's why we do those things. We are sitting too long. Move around. Spread out, spread out, spread out. Here we go. There we go. Stand up. We're going to do Che Che. You know, let's exercise. Che Che Kool-Aid.
Che Che Kool-Aid.
Che Che Kofisa.
Che Che Kofisa.
Kofisa Langa.
Kofisa Langa.
Takashi Langa.
Takashi Langa.
Nice job. These are Grandma's glasses. This is
Grandma's hair.
This is the way she folds her hands, lays them in her lap.
These are Grandpa's glasses.
This is Grandpa's hair.
This is the way he folds his arms.
Grandma and Grandpa, love it. Let's do one more warming up of our voices and our bodies. This one is a little jazz song we like to call Grandma Moses. Put that jazz in your feet, find your spot, and show me your smooth moves. Real super smooth moves. You can spread out, boys. In your space. Look at Asher go. Love the toe tapping. Hand in the pocket, Mason, that awesome. Exercise song again, just to focus the body, get the body moving to the beat. Grandma's glasses is a vocal pitch exploration warm-up activity, getting the voice high sounds. Grandma's,
Grandpa,
high and low, just basically. Grandma Moses, the jazz one we just did, multicultural jazz style, repeated rhythmic pattern that you have to say, rhythmic flow helps with reading, rhyme. And then all the movements that we're doing again is another way to warm our bodies up. So let's move on to warming our voices up. Oh. These activities are called pitch exploration. Huh. I'm looking for those. And what you do with pitch exploration is, this is how you teach to sing. Kids know how to sing. And our kids learn how to sing, and it is a teachable skill. So if you walk around and think you can't sing, or you say to an adult, I can't be in your choir, I don't know how to sing, maybe not your fault. Maybe you just weren't taught. Because it is something you can teach, and it's something you should start young, because they have no fear. And so you start it young, and I have fifth graders that sing with joy and no fear. So let's continue that. We're going to do this first, Cowboy Joe. Was a bold young man. He dreamed of rustling cattle most of all. He wanted to see if those cows would come when he let out his cowboy call.
Yeehaw!
Well, he practiced all day from morning till night. He practiced in the summer and in the fall. He knew someday he'd have a chance to try out his cowboy call.
Yeehaw!
Well, one day it was proudly announced that his ma and his pa and all heading on down to Grandpa's ranch, so he let out his cowboy call.
Yeehaw!
Well, he jumped for joy, he ran for his gear, and then he came back down the hall, hopped in the car, and he was ready to go, and he let out his cowboy call.
Yeehaw!
When he, let's see, what happens next? Let's see, when he arrived at the ranch, he was happy to see that the cattle were not in their stalls. So he crept to the field where they quietly grazed. And he let out his cowboy call.
Yeehaw!
and he felt about 10 feet tall. I'm Cowboy Joe. You see how those cows come when I let out my cowboy call?
Yeehaw!
That surely was some day for Cowboy Joe when he sure did have a ball. Hey, now he's waiting to try out bigger and better things. He's practicing his
elephant call.
So the yee-haw part is the singing sound I'm looking for. Any sort of vocal exploration up in that range, any sort of activity that gets them going up there, that's all I want in kindergarten. I will tune it in later. I need the high sound. That's what we're working at. Here's another game. This is Monkey See, Monkey Do. Those of you with the streamers are doing the sound effect. If you do not want to do the sound effect, let me know and I'll pass the streamer to someone else. You okay with doing the sound effect? Okay, stand up, spread them out. Here we go. Count to eight. I'll come to you. Nice job. All right, so. Typical class. All right, kids, nice job on that. Thank you for being solos. All these kiddos are experimenting with sound. And we encourage that. So I thank you for doing that, kiddos. Let's move on to, that also was a steady beat activity, you know. You can, a lot of these things double for many reasons. Let's see, we are on to easy sing and call and response. Okay, these are good. These are good. I'm going to go over here. Easy to sing and call and response songs are how you sing in tune then. Once they find the high sounds and can they feel comfortable up there, then you start having them model or echo certain pitches, certain small ranges, maybe three or four different sounds, and they try to echo those sounds accurately, rather than a whole song with lots and lots of different sounds. You just focus, you narrow it down. So this song is called Tony Chestnut. Here we go.
Watch.
What do you do with our eyes?
Keep
them
watch.
Okay. Open mouth, sitting tall.
Tony
people sing in a duet?
Two
people. So I have two volunteers to sing in a duet. Ryder and Maya, since you're next to each other. Stand back there, bye guys. That'll be a good duet. I think their voices will blend. You ready, you guys? Here we go. With them around February 14th. Let's do another rhyming song. And think of your animal now, kids, because this is an echo song. I go crazy. Oh.
Down by the bay.
Good, I got it stopped. Average.
Have you ever seen a goose kissing a moose?
That's a rhyme, we're gonna sing it.
Have you ever seen Goldilocks eating chicken pox?
Now, there's a whole bunch. Let's go to Mason first.
Did you ever see a moose
kissing a goose?
A moose kissing a goose? Have you ever seen a moose kissing a goose down by the bay? Evan?
Have you ever seen a fox eating a tox?
Tox box. Sony, did you have one? I'm sorry, did you have one? Okay, what's yours? Spider.
I have one.
That one, Sonia?
Have you ever seen a cat eating a gnat?
A gnat! Yeah. Very clever, very clever. All right, kids, we're going to all our last one, and then we're going to move on. What's yours?
Have you ever seen a spider eating apple cider?
That's a good one. Spider apple cider. Those are so clever. All right, so I guess I can do one more while I'm passing out scarves. Does anybody have the last, final rhyme of all time? You want to go pink?
Okay, pink
orange. Orange. All right, take it. Awesome. Need these pastels. Here we go. I gotta make sure I get the bottoms. I need some reds, yellows, and greens, and purple, and purples. Do purple, red, yellow, green. Green, warm, yellow. Ready? Everybody have one?
Yeah.
Everybody has one? Alright, kids, this is our song for singing. I mostly want singing, so make sure your voices are using your mouths nice and open. Ready for the color?
Yeah.
Here we go. Pretty song coming. So this is then the next, an easy song that we have them sing without me. Ready?
fly fishies. Fold them up for me, please, and sit. Fold and hold. That's the directions. Fold and hold. Don't put them in the bin.
One, two, three.
Okay. While you're folding and holding, I'm going to give you directions. Are you listening? Yes, yes, yes. I will call your color scarf. So sit down. When your color scarf is called, you put the scarf in the bin, and then you need to come get a bell. Now we're going to talk bell for a sec. You must carry the bell in the quiet position. Do you all know what the quiet position is?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why is this the quiet position? Aubrey?
Because it doesn't hit the side and it doesn't vibrate.
It won't vibrate because the ball can't hit the side. Excellent. That's science. Science. So we're in a quiet, and another reason why we hold it is because it hurts
our ears.
Yeah. Got people here. They don't want to hurt their ears. If you have an orange or a yellow, scarf's in the bin. Bell's over here, and then sit in your place on the squares. If you have a pink or a red, go ahead.
Where do we put
them? Over there, Dom. Good, quiet bells. I like that. All right, ready for greens? Looks like there's a lot of greens out there. How about blues? Keep them quiet. You can fit in your space, fence. Red, is there any red? Purples? Ryder, I need your purple. Everybody else?
I want the red.
You got it. It looks good to me. Oh, you want the low one?
I want the low one.
See if you can find a low red. Maddie, go to your spot. Oh, music's almost done, Mason. Let's go. Shh.
Addie's holding.
That's the low. Yep, yeah, that's a low. Oh, did I call red? Did I miss red?
No.
Okay.
I was calling.
Oh, you folded it for me. Well, thanks, Addison. Love it. Okay. Do we have any yellows out there?
Yes.
All right. You're our only yellow, Everett.
No, Evan.
Evan. Adults, if you want to plug your ears, they're going to have practice time now. This is quiet signal. I'm warning you. If you want to plug your ears, we're going to do it. Ready? Go ahead, practice. Right?
Yeah.
I tested them all.
Yeah.
I know it. Okay, don't play them anymore. Okay. They're going to hurt our visitors' ears. We're making music, not noise. Not the noise room. Yellow, ready? Where's my pointer? Ready, yellows, and play. One of those. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One. I missed my orange.
There's only one orange.
Then you better be ready. Here we go, light blue, go. Got orange? Yellow? Sounds good. Light blue, dark blue, light blue, green, orange, yellow, green, blue, orange, there it is, yellow, who's got yellow? Let me hear your yellow. Is it working? Yeah, ring it up, don't hold the bell. Oh, I heard my ears too, Evan. Oh, let me talk about this piece. This is the New World Symphony Melody. This is Dvorak's New World Melody. He came to America in the early 1900s and was so impressed with the people and the land, he wrote a whole symphony devoted to America. The melody is really beautiful, and if you listen carefully, we can play it for you.
I'm not in this song.
Okay, let's do it quick. Yellows, go. Thank you. the tune, it's there. All right, let's do this one. I bet you might recognize this one. Ready,
yeah.
And. Ready again? Green? Okay, and then finish up with blue, blue, green, green, yellow, yellow, orange, blue, blue. Starts with red, 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 blue, blue, dark blue, dark blue, light blue, green, green, yellow, yellow, orange, orange, red. Yay! Okay, you know what it looks like? All of them in the quiet position. All right, the directions are, let's see. We're gonna make a circle. So, when I call your color, put the doll away and make a circle. Orange and reds first, please.
Why are we going to?
We're gonna do Old King Glory.
Yay!
Red,
yeah.
Orange, and go ahead, put your bells away. Don't play them.
I'm quiet.
Play
my
yellow, orange can go, yellow can go, yeah.
Blue?
Wait.
Green?
How about green? Looking good. Make a circle standing up, and greens can go, Wesley, and all blues. All right, let's make a circle.
I'm on you.
Yeah, I'm going to help make a circle.
I want to be the king.
What are you doing here, though?
I'm filming. Filming you.
Okay. You guys hold this. You guys close the circle. There you go. We're gonna play. You can drop hands so you don't stretch your arms too much. Just for a sec. That last activity, the bell reading activity, you can see all the benefits. Reading left to right, color recognition, melodic line, knowing when the notes go up and down. Beat one, and the longer ones representing more than one beat. So lots of stuff that's leading into, we'll talk about and narrow down in first grade and give it names. Okay, this game is called Old King Glory. Let's do this because of the time. We're really short on time, kiddos. Instead of the third person only, one, two, and three come out.
Oh.
Do you understand?
Oh.
I don't want to surprise anybody. I'm going to say that again. Instead of just three, one, two, and three come out. Okay, just to make the game shorter because we have to continue.
Okay.
All right, hold hands. Let's sing. Let's go this way. Moving this way, boys, girls, go this way. And,
Old King Glory of the mountain. The mountain was so high that it nearly got up to the sky. And it's one, two, three, follow me. Old King Glory of the mountain. The mountain was so high.
You get to pick the next three, though. Go on the end, and you can pick the next three.
Okay. Old King Glory of the mountain. The mountain was so high that it nearly touched the sky. And it's one, two, three.
And it would have been, Wesley, would have been you, honey. You were in the middle. You were in the middle.
No, that was not me.
It would have been Asher, honey. You're out. You're
yeah,
in.
That was Everett. That was Asher.
Oh my God!
I saw.
This game is
you're
terrible.
In. You're in. Wesley, buddy, it did come to you. He
yeah.
just went in there and ducked
it.
But you just did the next thing, okay? Oh. King
Glory of the mountain. The mountain was so high that it nearly touched the sky.
Yeah.
one. Okay, make your circle. Down. This is a beat game. On the report cards, I'm giving you a beat score for each child. This is the way I might assess it. From the point, as we sing the song, you're going to see it, you're going to hear it. It's visual, it's kinesthetic, so they can see if they end up self-assessed. So this is the way I'd assess it, just to demonstrate this activity for you. We're going to do engine. Count to four. Count to four with me. Ready? Start the top.
Thank you.
back to our friend. It got messed up. But you can see that's a really, you have to have coordination, you have to have the beat, your neighbor has to have the beat. And we usually get back to our same beat buddy, but we don't have time. I'm going to collect these. We got one more thing to show them. One more thing. Let me come around.
Who is this?
They're all mine. Here. Don't miss.
I can make it.
Don't miss. All right, stand up. Let's see who our partner is. We're going to switch for Kinder Polka. All right. Reed, hands to yourself.
Okay.
So start. Ask the parents to start.
Everett, Wesley, Jackson, Rob, Everett, Wesley, to start, okay?
Looks like I'm in.
That
would be funny. Play. All right, so into the middle, 1, 2.